Hi, I'm Dara Hitchcock. You're watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. It's time to talk Liam Neeson. And fortunately, we get to see Liam on the big screen. A lot of things are virtual these days. We're Zooming from the home office. Liam stars in The Marksman, where he plays an Arizona rancher living on the Arizona-Mexico border. He ends up rescuing a young boy who crosses the border trying to escape from a Mexican drug cartel. Harkins Behind the Screens had a chance to Zoom with Liam from his home office. We talked about road trips, growing up on a ranch or farm, and why his young co-star probably needs to get to a Harkins theater a little more. Take a look.
I worry about you.
Out there in the middle of nowhere.
All by yourself.
I will let you know that Harkins Theaters, which I work with, the largest family-owned theater chain in the U.S. based here in Arizona, is open, so we get to see Liam Neeson on the big screen.
Great, great. Well, that's what the movie was made for. You know, it was made for the big screen.
I'm from Pima County Merchants Bank. Let you know that the ranches be sold at auction.
I just need a little time to sort things out.
It's interesting. You play a, quote, hardened Arizona rancher, but you filmed this in New Mexico. Did you spend any time at all with hardened Arizona ranchers?
We had a couple of cattle wranglers. I guess you would say they're cowboys or dash farmers. I was brought up on a farm in my early years as a kid. My uncle had a farm, 40 acres or something like that. So every summer we were sent up there to cut hedges, make hay, milk cows. So I kind of feel it's sort of in my blood.
What the hell were you thinking taking that kid?
They were gonna kill him. They were waiting for him at the border.
You damn well ought to appreciate what I'm doing for you.
If you want to help me, you take me back. I'll find my own way home.
I was so fortunate to get to talk to your son for the film that you both did together, and we talked about road trips. And one of the things I asked him, because this film partly is a road trip, you and this wonderful young actor who I was not familiar with, but I asked your son on a road trip with you, who would be driving and what would you be listening to? And he threw you under the bus and basically said, you like to listen to BBC, which puts him to sleep. Is that what you're listening to on a road trip?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay.
Interspersed with a little bit of Pink Floyd or something like that, you know?
Okay.
Dire Straits. That's my generation, you know?
What was the best road trip you've ever been on? Because I love a good road trip, especially now. It's actually fairly safe to do, but what was the best one you've ever taken?
What's the best one I've ever done? Well, I've driven through various parts of the States. Did a lovely trip up Italy. With the Amalfi Coast up to Milan. I've driven around Ireland. It's a small country, but I've...
You've covered that a few times?
I've done that a few times, In Scotland, too, done that, and England. But I'd love to do a big, full American, you know, start in New York and end up in Los Angeles or something.
He just needs someone to give him a chance.
I want to ask you about Jacob. It's funny, you basically had a say in who was cast. So they give you this young kid's tape. What was it about him where you knew, you know what, we found Miguel?
He was, there were two kids, and it's not to put down the other kid who...
Right.
Had experience and was a lovely little actor. But when I saw Jacob on the screen, he was just it. Mm-hmm. He was real. He was just, and he had that kind of, had a little dangerous quality to him and a little sadness back there, the back of his eyes. And when he smiled, like the world lit up. I'm very, very fond of him. We formed a nice little relationship together.
Was he even familiar? Had he seen Schindler's List? Does he know about Love Actually? Like when you're working with somebody, you have to go, all right, I won an Oscar for this. Here's this one. Like, what do you say?
No, he asked me once when we were in the truck waiting for the lights to be switched over or something. He was asking me what I had done. And I said, well, Jacob, I've done 63, 64 movies. I rattled off some and he's just looked at me like, and then I mentioned Star Wars.
Looks like you had a little incident.
Yeah.
By the way, Liam used the same stunt coordinator, his good buddy Mark, who has been with him for decades. Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And I love to remind people that the best deal in town is still the Loyalty Cup, the 2021 Loyalty Cup, celebrating decades of the ultimate movie-going experience at Harkins, available at any Harkins Theater.